subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Geshi Chonsong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 25th of August. India anticipated Taliban takeover in Afghanistan, says Chief of Defence Staff. US President Biden says Afghan evacuation on track as humanitarian crisis looms. LGBTIQ community in Nepal demands recognition, equal rights. And now for all the details. India's Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat on Wednesday said that India had anticipated Taliban takeover of Afghanistan, but is surprised over the speed of it happening. He assured the country is prepared amid concerns over a possibility of rise in activities of various terror groups. India's Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat on Wednesday said that India had anticipated Taliban takeover of Afghanistan, but only the timing of the Ashraf Ghani-led government's collapse had caught everyone by surprise. Speaking during a think tank event in New Delhi, General Rawat said, "It is the same Taliban that was there 20 years ago. Only the partners have now changed." He said India has already done contingency planning amid concerns over possibility of rise in activities of various terror groups.
So as from the Indian perspective, we were anticipating a Taliban takeover of Afghanistan. We were concerned about how the terrorist activity from Afghanistan could overflow into India. And so to that extent, our contingency planning had been ongoing and we are prepared for that.
Meanwhile, Afghan refugees in India continued their sit-in protest outside the UNHCR office in New Delhi for a third consecutive day. They said they won't budge until their demands for refugee cards, resettlement options to a third country and security are not met by the refugee agency. They said they fear repetition of the previous era of Taliban rule in Afghanistan and have lost hope and want a more permanent solution to their settlement.
मुझे मेरा फ्यूचर दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है क्योंकि हमारा ना तो यहाँ पे एजुकेशन होता है ना तो हमें पढ़ाई करने का मिलता है हमारा फ्यूचर मतलब बिल्कुल अंधेरे की जैसा भी यहाँ पे दिन रहा है मतलब गुजर रहा है बिल्कुल
India has evacuated over 600 people including 228 Indian nationals from Afghanistan amid the evolving situation in the war-torn country. It has said it will also issue emergency e-visas to Afghan nationals who want to come to the country. Highlighting its concerns over Pakistan-based terrorist organizations at the United Nations Human Rights Council meet, India on Tuesday hoped that situation in Afghanistan does not pose a challenge to its neighbors and the Afghan territory is not used by terrorist groups such as Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed to threaten other countries, as it pleaded for an inclusive and broad-based dispensation in Kabul, representing all sections of the Afghan society.
India on Tuesday hoped that the situation in Afghanistan does not pose a challenge to its neighbors and the Afghan territory is not used by Pakistan-based terrorist groups such as Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed to threaten other countries. In his address at a special session of the UN Human Rights Council on the situation in Afghanistan, Indian Ambassador to the UN in Geneva, Indramani Pandey, on Tuesday pitched for an inclusive and broad-based dispensation in Kabul, representing all sections of Afghan society, adding that voices of Afghan women, aspirations of Afghan children, and rights of minorities must be respected.
Voices of Afghan women, aspirations of Afghan children, and the rights of minorities must be respected. Stability in Afghanistan is essential for peace and security in the region. We hope that the territory of Afghanistan is not allowed to be used by terrorist groups such as Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed.
Terror groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed have been fighting alongside the Taliban against the US-led forces in Afghanistan for the past several years. Over the years, the two terrorist groups have primarily focused on India, where their missions involve carrying out direct terror attacks, infiltration, indoctrination and sabotaging of New Delhi's interests. Earlier, India also raised the issue of cross-border terrorism and activities of Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed at the meeting of BRICS representatives responsible for national security and said that these groups enjoy state support and threaten peace and security. The representatives adopted and recommended the BRICS Counter-Terrorism Action Plan for consideration by the BRICS summit. The action plan aims to further strengthen existing mechanisms of cooperation in areas such as financing and combating terrorism, among others.
In news from Afghanistan, U.S. President Joe Biden said U.S. troops in Afghanistan faced mounting danger as they pushed to complete evacuations by an August 31st deadline, with aid agencies warning of a looming humanitarian crisis for the population left behind. Tens of thousands of Afghans fearing persecution have thronged Kabul's airport since the Taliban takeover, and the United States and its allies have evacuated more than 70,000 people.
U.S. President Joe Biden said on Tuesday that he told G7 leaders the United States is on pace to complete the U.S. pullout from Afghanistan by August 31, but that doing so will depend on cooperation from the Taliban. In a televised address after his G7 meeting, Biden said that meeting the Taliban must not disrupt U.S. operations or access to Kabul airport for the deadline to be met. The United States and its allies have evacuated more than 70,000 people, including their citizens, NATO personnel and Afghans at risk, since August 14, the day before the Taliban swept into the capital, Kabul. Western countries are now rushing to complete the airlift before the deadline for the withdrawal of foreign troops under an agreement struck with the Taliban last year to end America's longest war.
We are currently on a pace to finish by August the 31st. The sooner we can finish, the better. Each day of operations brings added risk to our troops. But the completion by August 31st depends upon the Taliban continuing to cooperate and allow access to the airport for those who were transporting out, and no disruptions to our operations. In addition, I've asked the Pentagon and the State Department for contingency plans to adjust the timetable, should that become necessary.
Meanwhile, Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid in a press conference on Tuesday said all foreign evacuations from the country must be completed by August 31 and asked the United States to stop urging talented Afghans to leave the country. The Islamist group has told the Afghans crowding the airport in the hope of boarding flights that they had nothing to fear and should go home. Despite that, crowds of desperate Afghans continued to gather outside of Kabul's airport in the hopes of evacuation on Wednesday, some standing in knee-deep water amid trash and near barbed wire, as aid agencies warned of a looming humanitarian crisis for the population left behind. Tens of thousands of Afghans fearing persecution have thronged Kabul's airport since the Taliban takeover.
In news from Pakistan, Afghan refugees living in Pakistan for decades have expressed that their hopes of returning to their homeland have been dashed by the Taliban's takeover of Afghanistan. They said there is uncertainty about any future in Afghanistan as more people try to flee, while the war-torn country also faces an economic crisis ahead.
Afghan refugees who have lived in Pakistan for decades said on Tuesday their hopes of returning to their homeland had been dashed by the Taliban's takeover of Afghanistan's capital, Kabul. They said there is uncertainty about the future in Afghanistan as they hear news of people fleeing from the country, fearing a brutal form of Islamist government Taliban ran during their rule 2 decades ago. Pakistan is already home to over 1.4 million Afghan refugees, according to UN Refugee Agency data, and more Afghans have continued to pour into the country after the recent developments.
Afghanistan هغه امید زمونږ پاتې شو ځکه آینده لپاره څه پته لګي چې کوم اسې حالات به راځي افغانستان.
Meanwhile, more than a week after Taliban's lightning seizure of Kabul on August 15, residents in the Afghan capital said they faced skyrocketing commodity prices while the Afghani currency has plunged and banks are still shuttered. Even before the Taliban swept into Kabul, conditions had been worse, with rapid advance by the insurgents through the provincial cities, sending the value of the local Afghani currency plunging against the dollar and pushing prices of basic foodstuffs even higher.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The CPN-UML Communist Party of Nepal Unified Marxist-Leninist Chairperson K.P. Sharma Oli has urged the party leaders and cadres of the splinter faction led by Madhav Kumar Nepal to return to the mother party. Addressing a press conference organized on Tuesday, Oli said the party will move ahead in unity. CPN-UML in its standing committee meeting on Tuesday also decided to treat everybody equally without any prejudice if they return to the mother party, said spokesperson Pradeep Kumar Gyavali. He added the party body also decided to revive all party structures and committees that existed before the UML's merger with the CPN Maoist Center. Meanwhile, as many as 55 Central Committee members and 30 lawmakers of the CPN-UML have authenticated the newly registered CPN Unified Socialist Party, led by Madhav Kumar Nepal. If Nepal is able to garner the support of 20% of members of either the Central Committee or Parliamentary Party Committee, he will be able to successfully form a new political party. More news from Nepal. Wearing vibrant costumes and rainbow-coloured masks, scores of members of LGBTIQ community gathered in Nepal's capital, Kathmandu, earlier this week to celebrate Pride Day. They raised concern over the discrimination they face and demanded recognition and equal rights.
Scores of LGBTIQ community members in Nepal gathered at the Basantpur Darbar Square in capital Kathmandu earlier this week to mark Pride Day amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Wearing vibrant costumes and rainbow-coloured masks, the members of the community called for attention to their demands of recognition and equal rights. The newly promulgated Constitution of Nepal in September 2015 has a special provision for sexual minorities, but the group has been demanding its complete implementation. They claim they are often deprived of employment opportunities and discrimination.
हामीले चाहिँ पहिला सुरु भनेको चाहिँ हाम्रो लागि पहिचान नै सबसे ठुलो कुरा हो हैन जुन चाहिँ हामीलाई पहिचान अनुसारको नागरिकता दिने भनेर त भनिएको छ तर हामीले लिन जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ सहज रूपमा पाइरहेको कन्डिसनहरू चाहिँ छैन अनि अर्को भनेको चाहिँ सेम सेक्स म्यारेज लिगलाइज हुनुपर्छ सेम सेक्स म्यारेज लिगलाइज भयो भनेदेखि चाहिँ हाम्रो हक अधिकार पाउनको लागि चाहिँ अझ हामी सहज हुन्छ होला जस्तो
Nepal has a number of progressive laws when it comes to queer rights but same sex marriage is still not legal The queer group has finalized celebration, resilience and determination of the community as its theme for the year.
A banker in Western India has built a special bond with the pandemonium of parrots during the COVID-19 induced lockdown. About 35 to 40 winged friends visit her house every day, where she has added bird feeder and swings to host them.
During the COVID-19 induced lockdown, a banker living in India's western Pune city built a special friendship bond with a pandemonium of Indian ring-necked and Alexandrine parakeet. About 35 to 40 winged friends visit Radhika Sonavane's house every day. She designed open spaces in her rented apartment to accommodate these parrots and also added bird feeder and swings to host them. During the lockdown, Sonavane had started observing their timings of arrival and departure and what they eat. Eventually, they started trusting her and then started coming to her balcony, hanging on the feeder trees.
For 1.5 years, they were coming, but nowadays the number is increasing day by day, 30, 35, 40. And there are two types of parrots, so Indian ringneck and Alexandrine parakeet. So, earlier, the Indian ringneck used to come, but later on, Alexandrine parakeet they started coming in large number. So nowadays, they come every day. And in terms of relation, there is some kind of bond I have developed with them.
Sunavane said these birds bring her joy as she patiently waits for their arrival both in the morning and evening. However, now that the parrots are friendly with her, some of them only like to be fed by her hands.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.